Although Kenyan long-distance transporters last week called off their strike after Uganda suspended the mandatory testing of truck drivers at its borders following the East African Community Member States Interministerial Meeting, there is almost no difference in the number of trucks entering Uganda. This has majorly been blamed for the skyrocketing fuel prices, which have seen a countrywide shortage, with some petrol stations closing for now. When the news visited the Kenyan side, we discovered that it takes over 2 hours for a truck that is 1 kilometer from the customs of Kenyan side to arrive on the Ugandan side. However, the drivers have expressed optimism that at least they are now moving. One of the tanker drivers heading to South Sudan, Bashir Wanyama, said he arrived in Uganda yesterday and he's happy that the situation is now slightly better.
I arrived here at around 11. Now we are moving, the borders open. Each and everything is now going on.
Another driver, Somali by origin, Bin Saad, said he has hope that the situation will return to normal this week.
It will end at that time of this time. But it will end. I'm sure it will end.
And 1 week?
And more. It will end within 3 days or 4 days.
He said the situation in Kenya is still bad because of the long jam of over 75 kilometers. A driver heading to Rwanda, who declined to be named, confirmed that most of the clearing of trucks is being done at night and not during the day.
The clearance was having problem, eh? The clearance is having still problem. Which even if you see now, they are still stacking up to now. The people are coming to what the scanner was having problem, but now they have already cleared. But now they have
taken
the scanner, and now it's okay.
Yeah. What about is it true that these people are clearing you, they're only doing their work at night only?
Yeah, most of the time at night, that's the time the vehicle are moving. But during the day, they're going to be stopped too much.
Oguti Gata, a driver from Congo, said the jam has been a big punishment to them socially and economically. He accused some of the people of not being helpful. Efforts to speak to URA officials were futile. The truckers have been carrying out a silent strike since early this month, where they parked their trucks and sealed off the road to the Kenya-Uganda border, vowing not to cross into Uganda until the government harmonizes their positions, scraps the $30 COVID-19 test charges, or scrap the mandatory testing like the other East African states.
Uganda, happy!
Story by Wilfred Masaba for the news.